is the Writer's Almanac for Thursday, the 16th of January, 2020. It's the birthday of the poet who wrote the lines, "Were you ever out in the great alone when the moon was awful clear and the icy mountains hemmed you in with the silence you most could hear, with only the howl of a timber wolf, and you camped there in the cold, a half-dead thing in a stark dead world, clean mad for the muck called gold." The Canadian poet Robert Service, born in Preston, England, 1874, he was working for the Canadian Bank of Commerce in the Yukon Territory when he wrote that and his other famous poems of the Yukon. It was on this date in 1605, Book One of Don Quixote by Miguel de Cervantes was published, about the middle-aged landowner from a village in La Mancha, stays awake at night reading books about chivalry, forgets to eat and sleep, believes the stories are true, and sets off on his skinny horse in a heroic quest to resurrect old-fashioned chivalry and heroism in the modern world. It's the birthday of the poet and memoirist Mary Karr, born in Groves, Texas, 1955, had a rough childhood, grew up in a small town, alcoholic parents, her mother mentally ill. Mary Karr, author of poetry and also best-selling memoirs, The Liars Club in 1995, and two more, Cherry and Lit. Mary Karr, who said, "Memoir is not an act of history, but an act of memory, which is innately corrupt." And it's the birthday of the food writer Ruth Reichel, born in New York City, 1948, whose mother loved to cook but was terrible at it. Ruth Reichel remembered, "My mother really would make these dreadful concoctions. She really prided herself on something called everything stew, where she would take everything in the refrigerator, all the leftovers, and put them all together. One day I was watching her put in leftover turkey and broccoli and a little can of mushroom soup, and she's throwing things in, and half an apple pie goes in. In defense, I started cooking because I didn't want to eat that." Ruth Reichel, who became a great cook, a restaurant critic, and for 10 years the editor of Gourmet magazine. Here's a poem for today by Ron Padgett, entitled "Hug." "The older I get, the more I like hugging. When I was little, the people hugging me were much larger. In their grasp, I was a rag doll. In adolescence, my body was too tense to relax for a hug. Later, after the loss of virginity, which was anything but a loss, the extreme proximity of the other person, the smell of hair, the warmth of the skin, the sound of breathing in the dark, these were mysterious and delectable. This hug had two primary components, the anticipation of sex and the pleasure of intimacy, which itself is a combination of trust and affection. It was this latter combination that came to characterize the hugging I have experienced only in recent years, a hugging that knows no distinction of gender or age. When this kind of hug is mutual, for a moment, the world is perfect the way it is, and the tears we shed for it are perfect too. I guess it is an embrace." A poem by Ron Padgett, "Hug," from You Never Know, published by Coffee House Press and used by permission here on The Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.